Hello, this is Kurt Worley, FX strategist and trader coach at FXBootcamp.com. Today is Thursday, January 3rd, 2013. As I speak, it's a few minutes before 7:30 a.m. New York time. A little more than 30 minutes from now, we're going to see the open of the New York morning trading session. Sometimes we see unique volatility in the currency market at that time. Another source of prospective volatility coming up a little more than 45 minutes from now in the form of the U.S. ADP employment report. But I wanted to point out first and foremost, multiple sources of prospective support the Euro-USD is approaching. I'm looking at a daily chart for the Euro-USD currency pair on the One MT4 trading platform. And first and foremost, you can probably see the purple-colored uptrend support line. Let me highlight the swing lows that form the basis for that trend line. Lows established early in mid-November here. And then the December lows in here. And that trend line, as I have it, that trend line sitting somewhere in the 3070 to 3080 area. Again, the 1.3070 to 1.30 area. That's also worth noting, we've got a daily S2 pivot point, a classic support pivot point, just above 3070. I've noticed that the October 5th high for this pair, just north of 1.3070. And you can see on this chart, the October 22nd high at about 1.3083. There's the October 22nd high. So again, multiple sources of prospective support in the 1.37 to 1.30 area. Now, again, that could form the basis for a Euro-USD long somewhere in that zone. However, keep in mind that we do have used some U.S. news, and U.S. news could shake some things up for a little bit. So the aggressive trader could certainly go long at the touch of, say, the daily S2 pivot point, just above 3070, long at the touch of the trend line, or you wait for the news to pass and perhaps look for some sort of reversal pattern. Maybe you wait for a 5-8 cross on a 15-minute chart. Those are some of the options you'll have to consider depending on your trading style and depending on perhaps the reaction to the U.S. news, again, the U.S. ADP employment report.